Bonjour guys, welcome to a brand new FIFA 20 video, and today we will show you guys our custom tactics that we use for the formation 4-4-2 on FIFA 20 Ultimate Team. So guys, we have been grinding FIFA, and as you can see, we're in Division 2 with a decent skill rating, with a road to glory. We spent no money on the game, and bros, right now we're just gonna redeem our first ever FUT Champions access, because FUT Champions is starting this weekend. So bros, if you enjoyed today's video, leave a like, make sure you guys as well do subscribe to the channel for more FIFA 20 custom tactics, FUT Champions rewards, FUT Champions gameplay as well. So boys, let's get right on with the team and the custom tactics. It's important guys that you use custom tactics that fit your playstyle. Exactly. We're gonna give you guys more details about it. We're gonna change the formation to 4-4-2 in-game. So let's start with the custom tactics.
Exactly, boss, and this is gonna be something really important. We will actually advise you not to copy and paste our custom tactics, but to try to follow and understand what we say with what we are going to say with the custom tactics, like that you guys can adjust it to your playstyle.
So bros, we use pressure on heavy touch at the moment for the start of FIFA 20. I think it's the best one to use defensively. You can use pressure after possession loss. This is pretty good as well, but be careful because that will leave a lot of gap in the defense. Yes. I will not really recommend. And then constant pressure, guys, this is awesome, but whenever you're losing the game and you want to get back into it, draw back could be working, boys, for those of you, but for my playstyle, I don't really like it. Even though FIFA 20 drop back is back and it's pretty overpowered, balance or pressure on heavy touch, the whiff will be 6 out of 10. It's important that you guys, your full backs are not really too much in the middle, and as well your wingers too much in the middle, so 6 out of 10 is the perfect balance. Then after bros, for the depth, it's 4 out of 10, simply for the fact if you put too much depth, then you're gonna get caught in behind with long through balls, over the top through balls, which are pretty overpowered on FIFA 20, and if you put one, it's not really good because you'll be way too behind, way too much in the back, which is not really good. So 4 is the perfect amount. Then after bros, for our offensive style, we use balance. I think it's the best one. You can use long balls, but it doesn't really work on FIFA 20 for sure, guys. Fast build up if you're more like that counter attack tip on FIFA 20. Yeah, if this is your playstyle, fast build up could work. Possession, obviously, if you like to play tiki taka like the Barcelona way, could be pretty good. Possession could be pretty overpowered, but balanced, or balanced for us, this is what we use, because we have a good surrounding about everything, so balanced is awesome.
Yes.
Now bros, for the whiff, it's important that you guys, especially with the 4-4-2 guys, take the whiff, spread out the play. It's like in real life, whenever you have the ball, every time you have the ball in real life, you need to spread out the game. It's gonna be super important. Play on the box 5 out of 10, simply for the fact that crosses are not really that overpowered on FIFA 20 at the moment, actually. But you guys can have the second rebound. The second rebound with your midfielders could be pretty important. So 5 out of 10 is a decent amount. It's well balanced. Corner 3 out of 5. Obviously, guys, it's the same with crosses. Corners are not really effective. But if you play it short, you have more option. Either 3 or 4 will be the amount that we will recommend for you guys. And then after free kicks, 4 out of 5. Once again, crosses not so OP, but if you guys play it short, you have a lot of options.
Exactly, boys, and this is going to be something really important, because with the 4-4-2 formation, first of all, you have 2 strikers, 2 wingers, and 2 midfielders. If you guys know how to proper defend on that game, I do actually think that the 4-4-2 formation, it's one of the most well-balanced formation in the game. Of course, it might take you a couple of games to give it a try, but right now we're gonna get into the play instruction, in my opinion, the most important part of today's video.
Yes, really important instruction on FIFA 20, or vital for your success on how you guys can win way more games on FUT 20. So boys, for our fullbacks, it will be stay back while attacking, simply for the fact that you don't want your fullbacks to be way up top. No, it's not worth it. A fullback is there to defend, but with stay back while attacking, sometimes they will push forward, and their option whenever they are going forward will help out offensively. Now bros, for the two center defensive mid, or the two center mids, stay back while attacking, it's going to be really important, and cover center. Make sure you guys, it's really important, the defensive position, both of them gotta be on cover center. That's really important. Then after boss, for wingers, come back on defense, stay wide. If there is a winger that has a high defensive work rate, I will potentially put him into getting behind, and as well interception. aggressive interception, all right? But your wingers got to have a lot of stamina. Dembele, it's not really the case, so we leave it on normal and balance support for the support run. Same with Martial, come back on defense, stay wide. As it's the same, bros. If the player does have a lot of stamina, aggressive interception. Now, bros, really important for the striker, and this is where it's really specific to all players. The first striker will be getting behind and stay forward. We have stay forward for Wissam Ben Yedder because he does have less than 70 stamina.
Yes.
Hear me out, bros, on this. If your striker does have more than 85 stamina, I will recommend him to go come back on defense for the defensive support. And if you come back on defense, make sure you use aggressive interception because like that, you will become kind of like a 4-2-3-1, but a little bit more offensive because one of your strikers will drop down a bit and will help the midfielders to defend. So this is really, really good. Both of them balance with because there's two strikers and getting behind. This is the most important. Now, bros, for the attacking one, for the attacking formation, if you need to get back into the game, yes, press after possession loss or constant pressure with the depth. Make sure you guys use those amounts. Fast build up, the width. It's going to be awesome for this. It's going to be 7 out of 10 for players in the box, 4 out of 5 for corners, and free kicks. And then after, for the instruction, make sure you have your fullbacks on balanced attack. Your two CDMs stay back while attacking. Your wingers come back on defense, stay wide, it's the same. And then for your two strikers, stay forward, getting behind with aggressive interception.
Exactly, boss. And if you need to get back into a game, if you need to score, if you need to chase a result, then make sure to use Super Sub. The yes, most affordable Super Sub or the cheapest. And if you can take someone like Gelson Martins, if you take someone like Lozano, Keita, Baldejo, those will be great Super Sub to bring whenever you need to chase a result. And that's going to be super important, bros, within the 65th, 70th minute. If you guys chase, if you guys really need to score a goal, make some Super Sub.
Yes, and as you can see, guys, right now, this is a gameplay from hashtag United Pro Player. I think it's hashtag Shuri. It's one of the hashtag United boys. Fair play, boys. He was really, really good. I'm not going to lie, but he had an insane team. Obviously, with our road to glory, no FIFA points, no pay-to-win team. It's pretty difficult to compete right now in Division 2 against those players, but he was really, really a really good player. I won't lie to you guys, he was far better than me, but I think I still gave him a game. It's really important, boss, with the 4-4-2 formation that you guys take your time, all right? Whenever you get the ball back, take your time, build up from behind, use your midfielders, use your wingers, use your fullback. It's going to be super, super important, especially because with the 4-4-2, it's so well-rounded. It's a well-balanced formation on FIFA 20. Therefore, you have a lot of options everywhere. Yes. Through the middle, because you have four players with two strikers and two center mid. And as well, on the width, you have as well four options with the fullbacks and the wingers. So make sure you guys take your time. Spread out the game. It's going to be really important for those of you guys that are struggling, because every time you get the ball back, you're just sprinting forward, rushing forward. This is not the type of gameplay that will suit you for FIFA 20. It's important you guys take your time, and as soon as you see an opportunity, then you smash it. All right, boss, that's going to be important. Then after, for the second game, I came up against a lesser good team, if I should put it that way. It was obviously a good team, especially after a week of FIFA 20 is being released. But as you can see, guys, I try to find some occasion. I try to spread out the game a bit, and as well through the middle with the pace of someone like Rashford and the passing ability of Wissam Ben Yedder, I did some damage. Obviously, guys, this team that we're using right now is awesome, but our defense really need a massive upgrade, because in Division 2, having Upamecano and Konate as your center back, obviously they are cheap. They will make the job, but
and they're it's decent. Not bad. They are decent, but yeah, the big improvement was that we want to bring for the team for the road to glory. Now will be the defensively, because offensively with Dembele, Martial, Rashford, Ben Yedder, we know how to score goals in that FIFA, right? Yes. But defensively, I mean, and we saw it against the game against hashtag Shuri. Defensively, when it's Ronaldo, Mbappe, Neymar against Konate, Upamecano, well, it tends to be way more difficult to defend against those top forwards. So the next purchase for the team will be Eder Militao, maybe someone like Hernandez, Longley, those type of cheap OP center back.
Yes, Varane will be ideal. Varane, potentially Ramos as well, but obviously they do cost a lot of coins. We've been grinding our squad battle and as well really hyped up to finally play FUT Champions once again, guys. It's kind of weird to say it, but I'm actually excited to play FUT Champions once again. Yes. So it's gonna start in 3 days and 14 hours. Make sure you guys go follow our Twitch. It's in the top line of the description because you guys can watch us play live basically over there. It's pretty chill as well. And if you guys have any question regarding your formation, custom tactics, make sure you guys either talk to us on our live stream or leave us a comment in the comment section down below, or Twitter and Instagram. We have all of those social media, so make sure you guys go follow over there. Lastly, boys, I just want to say thank you so much for the support recently, boys. We smashed 50,000 subscribers, and right now we're on the road to 52,000 subscribers already on YouTube. So it's thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much for your support, for watching the videos, for giving us the support.
It means a lot.
It means a lot to Vincent and myself. So thank you both so much. With that being said, guys, if you enjoyed today's video, leave a like. Make sure you guys do subscribe to the channel to not miss out on our upcoming FIFA 20 Road to Glory episode and more custom tactics and player instruction videos on FIFA 20. This is only the start of the year, so make sure you guys subscribe with notifications on. With that being said, my name is Liam.
My name is Vincent. Catch you guys tomorrow.
Au revoir.